Hi guys, it's Kiarko here, back with another speed build. Today we are building a modern bar. This was requested by Nardvillain. Thank you so much for this request. I had a lot of fun doing this. I actually tried building this like bar several different times, and this is the version I finally settled on. I just have like a lot of different concepts in my brain about what this could look like, and I'm pretty happy with how the final result turned out, so I hope you are too. And again, thank you so much for this request. And as always, anyone, if you have any requests at all for any builds, any aesthetics, any, you know, challenges or cast ideas, just let me know down in the comments below. Ooh, that's kind of a tongue twister, isn't it? Let me know in the comments down below. But let me know, of course. I love hearing your guys' ideas, and I always try to, make them. But anyways, so we are building this modern style bar on, obviously, like a rooftop of this apartment complex. And originally this is supposed to be like a studio apartment or something like that, but I changed this to, obviously, a bar. The reason I did this is I kind of like the idea that maybe this was like the bar of some fancy hotel. You know how some hotels will have like rooftop bars and stuff? That's kind of like what I was going for here. Because otherwise it'd be kind of weird and random to have like a bar randomly at the top of a building, because like how would anyone ever find it? But I like the idea that it was like connected to a hotel and it was like an exclusive bar that you could get to by staying at this hotel. And it is a modern bar, and so the aesthetic we kind of go for is like, it's a little bit industrial, but it's mainly just kind of like dark, atmospheric, little bit luxurious kind of aesthetic. It's kind of hard for me to explain, but you guys will kind of get the sense of what I'm going for as we move, especially into doing the interiors. But you can kind of get a sense of what my color palette is right now. Obviously, I'm going with a lot of black. We're gonna have like these really cool kind of greenish, orangish marble floors later on, and the whole thing ends up looking very sleek and just a really cool place, I think. And we have the left side of the bar all basically in glass, which I think is so cool. It has a glass roof, and then each wall side is entirely comprised of windows. There's only one wall here on the left that doesn't have any windows on it. And that was just like for logistical reasons. But it kind of has this like glass box effect, which I think is so cool, because you're just sitting in there and you're just like surrounded by glass and you have like the whole cityscape around you. And I just feel like it'd be a really cool place to, you know, sit in and, you know, do bar stuff in. So this is a bar, and there's not really like any sort of like lounge space. It's mainly just like seating areas and like actual like bars where you like pull up a stool to the bar and stuff. That being said, I did imagine that maybe they would have like a small menu here. Like, it's not really a restaurant, but they have stuff for you to eat. And there's also like an area that plays like live music and stuff too. So it's not like purely like a bar. Like, there's other stuff going on, but like, it's not enough for it to be anything else than a bar. So yeah. I mean, you'll kind of get what I'm going for as we move along. But we are doing the interior now. I'm just trying to set up a space here for where, like, our main, showstopper is gonna be, like, our main bar section. And it's gonna be in, like, this little crevice square thing here. And there's the marble, you guys can see. It's really interesting. I've never used this marble before just because the color tones of it are, like, so weird. But I really liked the way it contrasted with the black walls and just looked really cool. But anyways, we are setting up our really cool, like I said, our show-stopping segment right now. So this is like the main bar area that you'll see when you walk in. Obviously, that elevator on the left, you would go around and then you see this big, really cool, fancy looking bar. It's got some gold tone accents, so we kind of like carry those through in other areas of the build too. But there's honestly not a lot of gold in this build. It just kind of like comes in here and there. But I'm trying to pick out some lights right now. They're gonna hang over the bar. I end up choosing these, which I think was a good choice. I feel like they kind of match the aesthetic more than the other lamps I was looking at. But anyways, right now I'm doing drink placement, I guess. I'm just trying to look for like bottles and drinks to put on the back, I guess it's like a back shelf. Just like the back, like, you know how when you go to a bar and there's like a whole wall behind the bar where it's like all the drinks and all the bottles and stuff? That's what I was doing here. Just trying to find as many drinks as I could that were in my color palette to populate this shelving unit. But I do feel like it ends up looking pretty cool. I do wish I had more drinks and I populated a little bit more, but I think it's enough, honestly, for just this particular part of the build. But now I'm gonna put in this lit up like table console thing, just for an added little lighting detail in the back, which I really think makes the whole thing pop a lot more. And then we're gonna put a mirror on either side, again, just for like added you know, cool aesthetic detail. But yeah, this is probably my favorite part of the bar, to be honest. Like, this specific bar area. It kind of looks like a little, what's the word? Like, the 1920s, like, oh, is it Art Nouveau? I don't remember what that style is called. You know, the very famous, like, decadent 1920s style. Kind of looks a little bit like that. But it's not exactly like that. It's just, like, vaguely inspired, I guess, with, like, the gold accents and stuff. But anyways, we are getting set up with our first seating area. So we have these big, long booths that are against this, like, really cool, like, overhang sculptural piece, I guess. And I really like how this looks, and I really like how, like, the atmosphere of it. I don't know, I just feel like sitting in one of these booths with this really cool, like, overhang, and, like, you have, like, the glass roof and all the light everywhere. I just feel like the aesthetic, or, like, the vibe of this place would just be so freaking fun to hang out in. And then on the other side, we're gonna put in some more tables. I couldn't quite fit in another row of booths, so we just put in tables here instead. And we're just gonna go with these glass tables that are just kind of gonna be the tables that we use pretty much everywhere else in the build. And then we're gonna put in some mirrors lining this wall so that people who are sitting on that side don't have, like, like, nothing to look at. At least they have, like, a mirror to look at themselves, I guess. And then back here on the other side of the, you know, the build, we're gonna set up a similar thing with some booths, and then we're just gonna put in some more tables. At this point, it gets a little bit repetitive, just because all I'm doing is, you know, table and booth placement everywhere, and I'm pretty much using the same, furniture pieces, just, you know, to retain a consistent aesthetic throughout. And we have this whole line of tables up against the windows, which would be a really nice place to sit. You know, you have the whole view, it's lovely, and yeah. This place has one bathroom, which would probably be problematic just because it's such a large place, and I'm assuming there'd be a lot of people here. So having one bathroom, you know, it would definitely have issues, but, like, it's fine, it's whatever. I didn't have other space to put, like, another bathroom, and honestly, I didn't want to take the time to decorate more bathrooms, so this place just has one bathroom. It's fine. They'll deal with the logistics. It's okay. And then we have our first outdoor area. So if you guys remember, there's, like, two outdoor areas. There's one on this side, and there's one on the other side of the rooftop. So this is the side that's, like, a lot bigger. So we have, like, another big bar up against the edge, and then we're gonna have a lot of little seats over here. And then on the side that's not covered is where we're gonna have our main stage for, you know, like, live music and stuff like that. I do recognize that, like, like, okay, first of all, I'm putting a grand piano here, and I feel like this grand piano, like, on this open rooftop would probably just have problems. You know, like, what if it rains? It just would totally screw up the whole thing. But, like, it's fine. I just think it's cool to have, like, an outdoor, you know, rooftop music area, even if it would be a little bit, like, difficult logistically, but, you know, whatever. This is not real life. It's just, you know, for fun. It looks cool. I like it. And then we have our other little outdoor area. This is a little bit more private, because it's just, like, a smaller area. So I figured this would just be, like, more, like, intimate seating area, and then we just have, like, these two big tables over here. And we are about done with the build. Thank you so much to Nardvillain for this request. I had a lot of fun doing it. You know, it was such a simple request, but I feel like you really prompted me to, like, access a part of my brain to, you know, design this, and I just had a lot of fun doing this. So let me know what you guys think of this build. You know, let me know if it's if it's the type of bar you would visit, if you get, you know, what I'm going for here. And as always, again, I always say this, but please let me know if you have any, you know, requests, suggestions, etc., etc. You can comment them down below. You can submit them on the Discord, which will also be linked in the description. And yeah, and join the Discord just for fun, because we're all there and we're all chatting and being friends and stuff. Anyways, as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.